Two teams go from there to Spain. Ray, we talked about how important this game is. We're seconds away from the opening kickoff.
And the player said it in the pregame interview, just exactly what you'll be said. They know what they've got to do. They know they've got to win this game, and I expect them to take the game to the U.S., although the U.S. have a strong wind at their back.
To take it, he takes all the corner kicks for the Vancouver Whitecaps, so no problem on this surface. Dangerous ball! Stojanovic goes up and heads it over the crossbar. Run on the side, and it's intercepted there. Now McGrain comes over. Oh, a bad move there. It goes off of Steve Petcher. Petcher looking for support in the middle. Iarushi comes out to watch Petcher. Petcher tries to get around Iarushi. There's the cross. Oh, a dangerous move, and it's just wide. Very close call.
I think that Ricky Davis has to be offside there. He was definitely in an offside position. A good run, and Petcher goes past Iarushi. It tries the shot, and it goes straight to Davis, but Davis had run in for the original shot and was definitely offside, but this shows how dangerous the United States can be on breakaways.
Liveric trying to turn Palaiko around, gets a good ball through to Ringo Cantillo, number 9 for the Americans, and Stretcher with a fine tackle. And then they get their legs tied up. Stretcher indicating that perhaps he took a knee in the chest intentionally there from Cantillo.
I think definitely that
Stretcher is down on the artificial turf here at Empire Stadium, obviously in a great deal of pain. Graham can only speculate at this point. It looks like a shoulder injury. Just how serious it is, we don't know. In case you've just joined us, I'm Steve Armitage along with Graham Leggett, and we're live. Free kick for Canada. It's outside the 18-yard box. There's the cross into the middle. Lefieri off the head of Sigoda. Ray forward for Stojanovic. Good ball. Stojanovic tries to get by Kaikio in the middle for Bruce Miller. Miller leads it for Beck.
No! Oh, that's a goal.
They haven't given it. It hit the bar twice, but it did not, I do not think, cross the line. What a wicked shot by Jerry Gray.
Well, I used to run to Gray. He hits it. Now, just look at it. Hits the inside of the post. Does it go across? The reason I shouted goal was that the linesman immediately went to the center of the field. Here it comes. Now you be the judge. You follow the flight of the ball, hits the inside of the post, bounces on the line. Hey, I don't know.
Loses it. McGrain just knocks it high into the air. Stojanovic running onto it. Stojanovic, a little bit of space. Oh, he's going to get by his man. No, he doesn't.
He's a penalty kick. The referee has given a penalty kick. Both fighting for the ball, and Dango Stojanovic, whether that was a penalty or not, it's up to the referee, and he's given it, but
perhaps he should be used to this, Graham, because he's been involved in many, many shootouts in the North American Soccer League. A chance for Canada to go up by two goals should Branko Sagota score on this penalty kick. Time of the year, beautiful BC. Throw into the box. There's McGrain off his head. Pino Lotteri, dangerous, and he keeps it out. Jerry Gray, what a strong game he's played for Canada. Gray for Bruce Miller. Myrna has people in front. Sagota! Oh, a beautiful opportunity there, and Sagota just couldn't get enough foot on the ball. Walt Chizowich and his assistant Bob Gansler on the American bench. Chizowich showing the concern of having his team down by two goals with only 20 minutes and 25 to throw back to Lefty area, and then a high throw for Jerry Gray. Gray working against two red shirts. Oh, dangerous situation here. McGrain. And he says to Tino, Canada still maintaining a 2-0 lead. 14 minutes and 55 seconds remaining to play. This is Branko Sagota. Sagota with a shot. Oh, and Mausser has to knock it over the crossbar, knock it high, and then turn and knock it over the crossbar. Canada will leave Vancouver this week and headquarter themselves in the southern United States. Play an exhibition game in Guatemala. Oh, there's a handball, I believe, but he hasn't called it. There's the shot. That is wide.
He has called it. Excellent play by the Canadian defender.
That used up about 40 seconds. We now have a minute and 57 seconds to play. Plus a little bit of injury time, I would suspect.
There's a chance for Lattanzi. Lattanzi with a shot. And it's cleared off the line by the American defender. Wes McLeod bends on the shot. Sagota has it. Canada keeping the pressure on.
For the injury. David into the middle.
Oh, and a goal! Yes! The Americans have scored off the corner kick.
And big Greg Villa, who was brought in just for his heading ability, took advantage of a defensive lap and just piled it past Lacey Harris. Canadian defender standing still here as David takes the free kick. It should never get that far. A great header, no challenge. And a guy is good in the air as be as you don't give him that amount of time. You've got to cover him and make it awkward for him.
Because the scoreboard clock has now run out. So we are into extra time. Referee looking at his watch. That's it.
The game is over. Canada has done what they had to do. They have picked up the all-important 2 points by defeating the United States.
A veces tirándose desde atrás, a veces apareciendo por el centro. Ahora intentando el gol, que consigue Adrián Camacho. Ese es Adrián Camacho, una realidad para el fútbol mexicano. Qué sentido para soltar la pelota, para jugar sin balón, para buscar el desfonde, para lograr resolver en el momento oportuno. Adrián Camacho da la ventaja al equipo de México por marcador de 2-0. Delantero flotante, 20 años de edad, jugador de Cruz Azul.
De México. José Luis.
Disparo, nuevamente José Luis, gol de José Luis González. José Luis, después del primer rechace defensivo, tomó la pelota, le dio una mejor dirección, angulándola pegado al poste. Imparable para el portero Wilson Dubois.
Colocan cuatro hombres cuando José Luis González está para tocar en corto a Hugo Sánchez. Aquí está Hugo, la finta, aquí está González, el desborde, toque atrás, gol.
Camacho en una perfecta jugada del equipo mexicano, en una jugada prefabricada, en una jugada estudiada que salió a la perfección, mejor no puede salir.
Falta dentro del área en contra del equipo mexicano, falta sobre Nancho, estaba ahí Alfredo Tena marcando y también estaba Arturo Vázquez Ayala, que fue cuando llegó, cuando Nancho quebró. Aquí está la repetición. Se cayó ahí Nancho y el árbitro está señalando falta en contra del equipo mexicano. Penalti en contra del cuadro nacional. Aquí está nuevamente la jugada, el quiebre, y cuando me da la impresión de cuando a Ricky Davis, que ahí va el árbitro Silva. Ahí sirve el árbitro Ricky Davis, gol del equipo de los Estados Unidos, perfecta la forma en que cobra Ricky Davis, la pena máxima para anotar el primer gol del equipo de los Estados Unidos. We'll be right back.